What I do is I create what I call tiles, these tiles out of different materials. This one is canvas, oil on canvas. And this is copper patina. This is oil paint. And what I do is I work on the piece in pieces so that I can change them while I'm working on them. I've always been inspired to make things and to take bits and pieces of things and put them together in either a collage form or bits and pieces of drawings and paintings and combining them. And especially as a printmaker, you do that anyway automatically. So I'm usually inspired by that. It is steel and magnets, but it's also a painting. It's also collage, and it's also sculpture. So I'm not sure what you call it. I call it steel mosaics, because you take different pieces and put them together to form one larger image. What I've tried to do with my work in the last 3 or 4 years is to take it out of the frame and give it motion, movement, and tangibility. And I would like for the viewer to put their own impression on the work, to really make it personal. But the main thing is to take it out of the frame and make it accessible to everybody, because I think the time of paintings behind glass is over. People want to interact with their work. The idea behind the work is that you can change it. It's a continually evolving piece. You can add to it, you can remove a piece and put it back in a different position. I like to create the piece with the point of view in mind that if the viewer decides to change it later, that's perfectly okay with me. I think that's really what I'm trying to say, is that nothing stays the same. Nothing is permanent. This type of art came probably mainly from my print making and the fact that I loved the plates almost more than I loved the images that I was creating with the plates. And so I became more involved in the middle process of it. Also, I've always wanted to create some type of movement on a two-dimensional surface. Something about Duchamp's nude Descending the Staircase and Bala's work and other artists at the time, that the Vortex group of people, artists, and the people in the Bauhaus, Kandinsky, Klee, they were into color and the psychological inclinations of the psychological interpretations of color. And that was always very interesting to me. And so this is a constant process for me that I've been working on for really years, and trying to create a movement on a flat surface. I was making books at the time. And again, taking form and making it flat and making it the same form, three-dimensional, was something that I was experimenting with a lot. And when I made the books, I thought of changeable book pages. And that's the time that I got the idea to use magnets rather than hooks and hangers that we had used. I thought it was just much easier for the viewer to remove one page and replace it with another with magnets. This is my advice to artists who are just starting. Press on. Nothing can take the place of persistence. Talent will not. Nothing is more uncommon than unsuccessful man with talent. Genius will not. Unrewarded genius is almost a proverb. Education will not. The world is full of educated derelicts. Perseverance and determination alone are omnipotent.